Brock better strike his way out of something, because he is not going to grapple with Wyatt.
Frank knows what he can and can't do.
Headlock drags him down.
All of his weight on top of Brock as well.
That's a good way to burn somebody's energy.
I can see Sensei Bok's head turning red right now. All the blood's being squeezed out of it. He's trying to wrestle with Frank Wyatt right now. You know, he may know more moves than him, but we've got a physics issue here.
Gravity is not on his side. I don't like where this is going.
No, I'm actually intrigued here. He must know something we don't. He is a martial arts master.
He's calling for the lockup. I don't think Frank is even taking this serious. Is he gonna do it?
What's the term? Key? Maybe Sensei Bok's key is stronger than Frank Wyatt.
That's possible. We're about to find out. That it doesn't look good already. Yeah, and there's a second hand. They're locked up. And he is crushing Sensei Bok. Oh, this is bad. Down to one knee. This is bad.
I think that Sensei Bok may be regretting this decision now. I think it's safe to say that Sensei Bok is, in fact, not stronger than Frank Wyatt.
Bok's back to his feet. Oh, kick to the midsection of Frank Wyatt. And an elbow to the head. Another elbow to the head. Wyatt is not budging. Another elbow to the head. Bok to the ropes. Sidewalk slam. That is a lot of weight coming down.
And when you're as big as Frank Wyatt, to string a bunch of strikes together, all you have to do is grab him and drop him.
Did you see the ring move when Wyatt missed that leg drop?
Here we go.
Drop by Bok.
Bok's figuring out the speed game and he needs it.
Wow, on one, Wyatt hoists him off.
The same way it only takes one attack for Frank Wyatt to get his opponent down, it only takes one miscalculation. One time of Frank Wyatt falling to the mat on his own, and he's hurt himself the same amount he would have hurt his opponent.
The Benjamin's using that speed advantage, taking his air away from him. Got him in the corner, boot to the chest.
Boxing's more focused at this show than he was at the last one. He's not spending a bunch of time arguing with the crowd.
Well, there you go, he's arguing with the crowd.
Except for that. All in all, I think he's gained quite a bit of wisdom in the ring since his last performance here.
Wyatt, several shoulder blocks, pushes Sensei nearly to the middle of the ring.
Might have been a head in there, too. Might have been a headbutt.
And Bok, that knee across the throat, making sure Wyatt can't recover. He's got to slow that man down.
He wanted the ref to count that, but he won't count it when he has the illegal, the shin over the throat like that. But he's staying on him. He's choking him now. He hasn't let Frank Wyatt get back to his feet. He's trying to keep the big man down, and that's a good move. Frank Wyatt can't throw Sensei Bok across the ring if he's not on his feet. Oh, so much for that.
Wyatt powering out of that.
That'll knock the wind right out of you. There's nothing pretty about Frank Wyatt's offense, but it works. He's a big man, but he's a smart man. He won't try any moves that he can't pull off.
Bok with the snapmare. Rolls him over.
Barely rolling him over. Frank Wyatt's just too big for that kind of move. Doesn't matter how big you are, you still need oxygen to function. And Sensei Bok knows that, and he's trying to restrict it. If he can cut off the air, he can keep Frank Wyatt down. And if he's lucky, maybe he can just choke him out and not have to knock him out.
Crowd is behind Wyatt. Oh, kick to the spine and a front drop kick. Wyatt is down, and he is hurting. Wyatt with the kick out.
I'm really impressed with the improvements we're seeing from Sensei Bach. His offense has been much more consistent and much more focused. Looks like, is he tuning up the band now?
Looks like it. Coming up and Wyatt shoulder blocks him out of the air. Wyatt running him right over again.
Sensei Bach is a good-sized man, but he looks like a child next to Frank Wyatt.
Bach going up onto the shoulders. He better do something. This looks bad. Fireman's carry, fireman's drop. Oh, that was a long fall. A lot of weight coming down on you. Oh, this looks bad. Leg drop. Oh, Wyatt dropping that gigantic leg across the throat. Bach with the kick out at two.
He is being squashed by Frank Wyatt now. But you can see now Frank Wyatt's getting tired. When you're that big and your moves are that powerful, it takes more out of you.
Each man retreating to a corner. Wyatt calling for a train. He's gonna...
Frank Wyatt is... Frank Wyatt is winded now.
And Bach drop kicking the leg out from under Wyatt.
You can run in a... See how slow he came in for the attack in the corner there. Frank Wyatt is out of air. As a big man like that, you can only maintain a certain pace for so long before you just run out of momentum.
Yeah, it looks like Bach's strategy's working. Oh, missing the kick though. Wyatt to his feet, going for the pile driver. He's gonna put this one away. Oh, and he just crumples Bach in the two.
And that's all it took. He may have been tired, but all he had to do was ram that massive head of his, that skull, into the ribs of Sensei Bach. Set up the pile driver, and that's all she wrote. But Frank Wyatt, he looks like he's just been through a war with Sensei Bach. Sensei Bach left his mark, and he left it on the chest and the back and the face of Frank Wyatt. What's this? A tremendous show of respect from Frank Wyatt. Indeed, bowing to the sensei tonight. Unfortunately, I have to go take care of some business in the ring.